toiling away in the tiny hut that doubles up as his home and workspace. It's one of the more dilapidated ones in his village, with not even a proper roof.
I work as a tailor. Sometimes I also work part-time as a factory worker. Whenever I get some work, I get paid. I make about $3 to $4 a day.
It's a hard life. His wife cooks a fresh meal every day. They have nowhere to store leftovers. Santosh has always wanted to make her life a bit easier.
I've been dreaming of owning a fridge for 10 years. Every month I've put some money away. Now I have enough saved up to be able to buy one.
It's a good time too. The final week of the winter sales with attractive discounts on offer.
It's a bit confusing, but I think I will get the one that consumes the least power. That's best if you live in a village.
Finally, the big day is here, and there's a huge sense of anticipation, all waiting to catch a glimpse. After all, the Chowdhurys are the first ones in the village to acquire a fridge. It's an auspicious moment, so a little ceremony to seek divine blessings and to welcome the fridge home.
I'm so happy. We've been dreaming of this moment for years. Many of the villagers also want to store their food in our fridge. And I'm looking forward to drinking cold water in the summer.
There are 40 houses in this village. About 200 people live here. Three quarters of Indians still live in rural communities such as this one. And over the past few years, their incomes have been steadily rising. And they're using the extra money to buy things that will help improve their lives, such as a fridge. As for Santosh, he's kept his word and made his wife happy. Sanjay Majumdar, BBC News, Calcutta.